good turnout, so Eskisson Positive seems to be doing well. That's very nice. So I want to say just a few words of introduction before we get on with the program. So some numbers first, so some statistics, that's always interesting, of course, besides the number of participants, also the number of influence on the program. So we had 34 submissions this year. That's not a record number, but it's well in line with what we had the last year, so we are healthy on that side as well. We program committee accepted 14 papers out of these 34, so that's about 40% acceptance rate. It's as much as could be fit into one day, really. So that was a long process, of course, reviewing, discussing the papers within the PC. We have, among those 14 papers, three special kinds of papers. So we have different submission categories for functional pills, which have the same length as regular papers, but are viewed with a different mindset and evaluation. And we have one experience report, which is a shorter paper, and it also gets a shorter presentation slot today. The one thing is, maybe for the future, so one thing where maybe we didn't do perfectly, we had much more, that 4, 5, or 6 submissions of experience reports that we found that we could only accept this one. So maybe that's something that community and also maybe future PC chair could try to explain better what we want to see in an experience report. So maybe that's something to think about for the future. So there were 128 reviews, there was a lot of work went into the evaluation of the submissions, of course, so that's almost 4 per paper, so at least 3 reviews per paper, and many, over half, had even 4 or 5 reviews, so we brought in external reviewers. In some cases where we had conflicts of interest in the PC, I brought in additional reviewers for those papers to make sure that everything is on the right track. And of course, we have a record number of registrations as well. So we have, yesterday morning, we had 198 registered participants for the symposium, which is not straightforward to compare with previous years, because this year we have these day passes, so people pay for the day and not for one specific event. So in previous years, people had to commit and really pay for each event that they intend to attend. But that's actually the number of people that said on their registration that they were going to attend the Haskell Symposium, even if you count off 40 or 50 double registrations involving other events, then we are still left with about 250 people who is only said that they are going to ask us about it. And we see it in the room that actually the organizers wanted to give us only half of the room originally, so there's a wall that you can get into the room, and actually decided that we will get the same venue as ICF Fields. So that was just content on that. Okay, some more statistics on the maybe on the program side. So there was one way to organize the reviewing also was that people on submission were offered a choice of topics and they could somehow say what topic their paper is about primarily, so they could make several selections, and they were given the options in alphabetical order, but that's the order in terms of how often topics were chosen. And you also see that application and libraries was present somehow in most or more than half the submissions. Language design seems to be very active this year. So I didn't adjust this perfectly, so for example, you could affect parallelism separate from concurrency. So I just used the same scheme as 3 years ago, so we can, if you want, make some comparisons. So the distribution in 2009 was somewhat similar. So maybe there's more activity in language design these days, but I don't know how much to read into this really. Also, the PC members were, of course, asked to make the same kind of selections, and I don't have the numbers here, but well, it shows that actually also the first 2 points were also what most PC members, or the highest number for PC members of their interest were also in application and libraries and language design, so there seems to be a good fit what submissions we got. But actually also for all of the other topics we had at least 3 or 4 PC members who explicitly said that it would be interesting in reading papers in that topic, so I think we had a good coverage here as well. Speaking of the PC, so that the names of the program committee members, and they really did most of the work, of course, in setting up the program. Many of them are here today, and I would like to really thank them for all their work in evaluating the papers, in discussions, in trying their best to give good feedback to the authors. Also, of course, we hope that the authors who are not going to present today profited a lot from this process, from the feedback they got. And I would like to ask the PC members that are present, which should be most of them, to stand up so that we can give them a round of applause. Thank you. are more people to thank. So we also, I already mentioned, brought in a lot of external reviewers actually. So for many papers we felt that we should get input from experts that were not within the PC, and also I brought in additional reviewers in some cases in order to mitigate potential conflict of interest within the PC. So there are too many names to put on the slide, but they are all mentioned in the proceedings, and they also did have got a very good job. Otherwise, they wouldn't have been able to do their paper selection in a short time, because that was really also a case of intense discussion. There's the Ask Us and Possum Steering Committee, which is a committee of members of the community which lives longer than one symposium cycle, so it's built by rotation, and it includes the previous chairs of the previous three events and some members at large, and of course they're always happy to help with advice, so I always also want to advise the next PC chair to really make use of that resource. There are the local organizers, we have already seen some of them. You will see a lot of students in, and also faculty members of DQ in blue shirts throughout the event, so they are the local people who will help to make this possible with all the arrangements, with setting up the venue, helping in talks, setting up the speakers. There are the local chairs for, or the chairs for at the interface between the main event and the workshops, Abit Janssen and Gabi Keller, who shielded the co-located event organizers from budget calculations, from having to interact with the publisher, which was also a big relief. And of course, I want to thank all the authors who provided the content of the program, and of course, all the participants, because otherwise it wouldn't be a nice event if we don't have the community present. I think that's really a good tournament. So thank you. Okay, and then there's only a few words left to say about today, about the format of the day and also of the talk. You've already heard about the breaks. We will have presentation slots of 25 minutes, that's longer than we had at ICFP, reflecting the stronger technical depth of the average Haskell symposium paper, I guess. So I decided not to go down to 20 minutes. So we had 25 minutes for a few years already. That also means that while we still have lots of breaks, we have a lot of opportunity to meet outside the hall and talk. Some of these breaks will be rather short, so we made an conscious effort to also synchronize the schedule with the ML workshop, which is taking place in some smaller room somewhere in the building, so we will have breaks together with them. Mostly they have different chunk size of presentation, so it doesn't fit everywhere in every break, but you should be able to mingle with them. Use this opportunity. Lunch is included, you've already heard about that, it's in the third floor, and as a warning to people also attending the last day at SFP, it's shorter than the previous days, also as a consequence of the arrangements and synchronizing of the slots with the NL workshop. So you will have not less food but fewer, less time to eat your food. So actually we'll start after lunch already at 1:45 instead of 2 p.m. Okay, and at the end of the day we have time for a discussion session. That's also a tradition that the Haskell Symposium has a future of Haskell discussion, or maybe also future of Haskell Symposium discussion. So we know that the Haskell Symposium has a future. It will take place again next year, again co-located with ICFP in the Boston area. It will be in the middle of September. The date is not fixed completely yet, but it will be again with ICFP. The program chair is also not yet decided, so that's one of the tasks of the steering committee, and we are in the middle of doing that, deciding who will be the chair of the next symposium. So this will also come to light in the next few days or weeks, I hope. That also means that I don't have somebody to take over the job of chairing the future festival discussion, because that will be the job of the next PC chair. So I decided that we will still have the discussion, and instead of setting, as last year in front of you, a panel of people to set the agenda, I will let you set the agenda. So I will have an open discussion session. If there are questions that you already have in mind or topics that should be discussed about the symposium or about future testing generally, then contact me in the break, send me an email, or just stand up in the afternoon to raise your point, and let's see what other people make of that. And if you don't have anything to discuss, you can still get fresh on the NL workshop for also having a discussion session in the afternoon. So I think we have also plenty to talk about ourselves. Okay, I don't know if there's anything else I wanted to say. No, the reception was already mentioned. Okay, yes, there's one thing. The order of presentation is a bit different than in the proceedings. So there were two slots that were swapped in the first session and the first afternoon session. Other than that, you can follow the order in the proceedings, and both the internet and also the leaflet that you got has the correct paper order already. Okay, then